out so they had an anointing of prosperity with them. They had a story of how God took Joseph from a pit to a prison and to a palace. So while they traveled, when they did not have food, they looked at Joseph's bones and said, remember how God provided for Joseph, and if he did it, and if he did it, if God delivered, if God delivered Joseph, God will bring us out. Somebody shout glory. Sometimes the short way and the short distance is not of God. Why will God keep you in that same predicament for 40 years and then tell you, now go and face your enemy and tell them to let everything that concerns you go, because God wanted you to see that when you was too weak to fight for yourself, that he fought for you. When you was too weak to stand on your own, he carried you. Isn't that a wonderful thing to be carried by God when I don't have any strength in my legs because I've been in the desert and I got weary? The Lord, he will carry me. That's when I say, I don't know how I made it. I don't know how I escaped it. I can't see how. I'm not crazy. I can't see how. I'm not on drugs. But I know the Lord, oh God, the Lord carried me. He is my deliverer. Say it. Yeah.
Well, thank you.
The place that he set, not the children of Israel. He said, follow me, and I'll tell you when and how to set up my house. I'll tell you what to do in it, and I'll tell you when to move. Some God has been telling you to move on. Why? Because some of you still somewhere mentally in your old church. And so God says, move mentally with the cloud where we at. Because you can't take things from the old and put it in the new.
Yes.
You're stuck. And when you are disconnected from the house that God has assigned you to, then you're stuck where you left him. You'll see that your lives will get back in order when you get plugged back into the right. Because some of us are still here, but that doesn't necessarily mean that we're plugged in.
Right.
You can be here bodily, but mentally you don't agree with nothing that this house stands for.
Wow.
And the reason why that's dangerous is because that's how the enemy plays tricks with you to get you up, to get you handling things that you have no business to handle.
Right. Yes.
God gave the rules to Moses.
Right.
How he wanted his house to be built.
Hmm.
What to go in there, what color to put in there, what color the priest should wear. He gave the leader the instructions, and he gave the people the ability to be obedient and submit. And so we stay in the desert until the nation, which is the people that God has assigned to this house, to measure up to God's way. And if that people don't measure up, God says, okay, well, we got to wait for them to die out so I can send more.
Wow.
It's in the wilderness.
Wow.
But we are going to see the promised land.
Amen.
We are going.
Yes.
And we're not going to have no leaders that are not going to be able to cross over because they acted out of character because of the stiffness in the people's heart. Lift your hands.